Yeah, so it cut off the video. I cut off. So whatever. And here's an easy solution to that. Okay, we're just going to subtract from one the base of the distance. So if we are 10 over 10, well, we could just say mathf.clamp to this 0 to 1 as well. Okay. And it's basically just going to leave an offset. So unless we are on the dead center, it's going to give us a seg value of 1. So from that, we could say camera manager screen seg or seg handler add screen seg and add the seg value. Then it's just a matter of changing the animator event in this case. Let's change the animation. Yeah, Windows animation. Change that and add screen seg by distance. Perfect. So I'm going to change this one to be able to attack by with that animation by maximum distance of 50. Okay, so if we are far away, basically nothing happens. If we're close enough, then it rocks our world. Awesome. So the other thing that I want to add is basically add some particle effects on attack. So let's see, I think we do have the object puller. Okay, so that's going to be to make this really simple. We can add some ground heat effects. Let's see, what do we have? I think we're going to have, we have some particles here and there. Yeah. Let's see, we have some smokes. I think that's too heavy. Let's see on misc candles. Maybe not. Let's do the sparks effect. Yeah, no, maybe not. Let's try some of these. Energy, big explosion. Probably too strong. Yeah, let's maybe try this. I'm just going to disable looping. On, let's unpack it entirely. Let's disable looping on everything. And then let's make this into a prefab. And since we do have the object puller, I'm just going to drop it here. An explosion, object puller, add that, and let's say explosion. Then let's go to our scripts on our animator hook. I'm going to say public void add particle. We have an ID for this. Okay, the only problem with this is that we don't actually know where we are going to be adding that particle in this case. But let's get it first. Let's see, we do have settings, object puller or no. Have utilities, object puller, get object, and pass the ID. Okay, so if we add it on our own position, you'll see that it's not really going to work that great. And let's go and add it again on the same animation. Let's add it. We can add it on the same frame. And let's see what we actually wrote. Add particle. Function, and we're going to pass the string of explosion. Okay, let's play that. Okay, it's not bad, but of course the positioning is entirely wrong at this moment. So how do we solve that? We first need to know where the actual attack is going to be, but the easiest thing to do, well, I think we can solve this in two ways. First of all, let's look at the enemy's attack collider, which of course is going to be under the sword. Okay, here's the attack. Then I'm going to open this up, and on trigger render, I'm basically going to save, or actually let's do owner. What do we have for the owner? Yeah, you're passing that. Okay. Well, for that we're going to need the animator hook. We can also be dragging and dropping this, but you know. And then I'm going to actually do on trigger, on collision enter. Okay, so we're now going to get some collision flags and so on. And well, if we just say that on animator hook we're going to have a public variable, with what we collided before in here, and we're saying we're going to be adding that there, then it comes down to saying animator hook dot collision position equals collision dot get, we have the contact, get contact, the first contact you're going to get, I think. And this returns your contact point, so from that you want the point. Okay, let's see how that's going to work, and of course if it's going to work. The only gotcha to this is that it actually needs to open, it actually needs for this, for the down, for the box collision to be opened. So let's take a look at the animation now, and we should have the other, yeah, we don't have animation events for opening the damage collision, so we should add those. And then in animator hook we want to use open damage collider and close damage collider. Okay, so I'm going to add an event before it opens, so over here, open damage collider, and sometime afterwards close damage collider. Okay, save that, and that should probably do it. Ignore the first part, we have it as playing on awake, and it does play, but what are we missing? I think we're missing, let's see where those are going on. Okay, then downwards collision or collision header. Yeah, we have, this is a trigger collider, so this will never play. So we will have to do other dot collider closest point. Let's try closest point. From transform.position. Let's do this. Don't know if that's going to work, but we'll see. Yeah, it doesn't. Oh, it does, but yeah, okay, it's wrong, as you can see. Closest point cannot be used with box collider, caps collider, and convex mesh collider. We probably have one. Oh, I think it's hitting his own collider in this case. We can test that. Bug.log other transform.name. Yeah, okay, no, it's hitting the ground. We can select that. We can turn that into a convex collider, it doesn't matter. It's just some ground. Well, I guess it does matter. Let's remove that and let's add a box collider instead. Okay, that's good enough, to be honest. Okay, that's one way to do this. The other way to would have been to just make it to just hard code with a transfer position on the enemy, since as you can understand, the animations are really based off the characters. You can just add some transfer positions where you know we're going to add, but this isn't really that bad either. Like, yeah, it's also not correct for the party, obviously. But that's good enough, I guess, for now. He could have hit us, but whatever. Let's see. Can he hit us? Well, he's not that perfect, I guess. Yeah, he can. Okay, so yeah, I think that's about it for this part. This was mostly just how we can add some more effects. I've got some things coming up which they will benefit having these animations, this extra stuff we can add on the attacks, that is. Okay, so that's it for this part as well. As always, you know what to do, like, subscribe, if you like to see more stuff, more videos, more series, more of everything, of course, consider supporting my Patreon, and we can keep making all of these nice things we're making. I'll see you next time.